So for 4 years you are given manufactured items and exported items for 3 companies. Numbers are in hundreds. Fine. What is the respective ratio between number of pens manufactured by C in all the years together and B in all the years together? This is about manufactured, C in all the years and B in all the years. Right, C, come on. You have 4 600s, extra 100 and 200, that is total 2700, and then 160. Total 2860, 2860. And B in all the years together, manufactured. If we add this 20 to 80, last two numbers becomes 800 and 800. So you have 4 800s and then 40, 60, one more 100. Total 3,300. 3,300. 0, 0 cancel. So numerator is 11 multiple. 26 times, denominator 30 times, 23 by 26 by 30, that is 13 by 15. Second option. Number of men manufactured by company B decreased by what percentage from 2000 to 2004? B manufactured decreased by what percent from 2000 to exported? Yes, exported 294 becomes 164, decreased by 130 from 294 into 100. What is 10% of this? Near about 30. How many 30s are here? 4. So let's go for direct 40%. Right, if you treat it as 10% as 30, 40% is 120, 34 times, correct? But this is 0.6 less than that. 4 times of 0.6 is 2.4. So you need to subtract 2.4 from 120, that is 117.6. Still, to make it 30, you need to add 12.4, which is approximately again 4%. So answer should be close to 44 and 45. Look at your options. Now, there are two options here. What is 10% of denominator? 29.4. 5%? 14 point something. But you need not add 14 point something. So answer has to be less than 5%. Yes or no? So this value is more than 4% but less than 5%. Answer should be in between 44 and 45. Look at your options. Over. Next. In the year 1999, the total number of pens manufactured by all the given companies together was 90% of total number of pens manufactured by all the given companies together in the year 2000. What was the total number of exports in the year 1999 by the given companies together if it constitutes 1/18th of total manufactured pens in that year? Exports, you're asked about exports. So manufactured in 1999 are 90% of pens manufactured in 2002 from all the companies together. Yes or no? 1600 plus 600, 2200 plus 90, 2290. Yes or no? Manufactured together? Right. And they said 90%. On this, we need to calculate 90%. But you are not asked about manufactured items. You are asked about exports. Exports are what fractional part they are saying? 118. So don't calculate 90% of the number. 18 how many times? 5 times. So you just need to calculate 5%. What is 10%? 229. 5% is half of that? 114.5. 114.5. Hundreds. Hundreds. Yes or no? Answer? put in 11,450. What percent of the number of pens manufactured by B in the year 2000 were exported? B in 2000 exported are how many? 294 out of 840. So 294 out of 840 into 100. Now, what is 10%? 84. Let me calculate 25%. That might be easy. Half and half, right? What is half of denominator? 420. Again, half of that? 210. To this, how much you need to add? 84, which is 10%, right? So answer is what percent? 35%. What is the average number of pens that were manufactured by company A in all the given years together? A in all the years together, average for manufactured items. This is what you are asked about. Let's take benchmark as 800. Yes or no? This is, last number is 100 more than that. Second number is 100 less than 800. Take 100 from last number and add 100 to second number. Both becomes 800. Yes or no? And first number has how much more than 800? 50. To make third number 800, how much we need? 10. Out of 80, take 10 and add to that to third number. Still you have? Now 40 adjusted among four numbers, each gets 10 more. So answer 800 plus 10, hundreds. 8, 10 hundreds, 81,000. Next, about take 640 minutes to travel from A to B and then back to A. The distance between A to B is 60 kilometers and the respective ratio between the boat is 4:1. Speed of the boat in downstream. Right. So, if stream speed and water speed and boat speed and what stream speed are 4:1, what is downstream speed? 5 part. Should be a multiple of 5, right? Downstream should be a multiple of 5. Yes or no? How many are there? 2 are there. Let me start with one number so that we can verify it. So, if 5 parts is equal to 15, 1 part is equal to 3. Then upstream becomes 3 parts, 3 parts is equal to 9. See, from this ratio, downstream is equal to 5 parts and upstream is equal to 3 parts. Because onward journey becomes downstream and return journey becomes upstream. If 5 parts is treated as 15, 5 3 times, so 3 3 is 9. What is total distance? 60. If it is travelled in downstream, and 60 kilometers is travelled in upstream. 60 by 15 in the sense, how many hours? 4 hours. And 60 by 9 in the sense? 6 hours and then 2 by 3 hours. 6 nines, 54. And then still you have 6. 6 by 9 in the sense? 2 by 3. 2 by 3 hour in the sense, how much? 2 by 3 hours in the sense how much? 40 minutes. So 6 hours, 40 minutes. Already to cover 60 kilometers in downstream, it takes 4 hours. What is total time? 10 hours, 40 minutes. 10 hours in the sense 600 and then 40. Total 640. Is that time given in question? Hence 15 is right answer. Are you followed? Otherwise, 60 by 5 parts plus 60 by 3 parts is equal to 640 minutes converts to hours by 60. How much is this? How much is that? 12 parts. And this one? 20. Total 32. 0, 0 cancel here. 32 how many times? 2 times. So this is 1 by 3. From this, 1 part is equal to 3. Matladru. Then 5 parts is equal to 5, 3 is 50. Instead of solving the equation, as you know that downstream should be 5 multiple, go for verification. Next, ABC invest in a business and the share of their investment is in the ratio 1 by 3, 1, 2 by 3 and then 1 by 8. So I don't want to use fractions here. Let's multiply it with denominator as LCM, which is 24. Multiply every fraction with 24, that becomes 8, 16, and then 3. After 6 months from the start of the business, A withdraws half of his investment. So this will be there for 6 months only. After that, as he withdraws half, remaining will be 4 and into 6. And B's investment and C's investment will be there for 12 months. Can we take 12 common and go for cancellation? Yes or no? 12 multiple in the sense, you can take it as 6 multiple and 2 multiple. 6 multiple, 2 multiple. 6 multiple, 2 multiple. 12, 12 cancel. Are you getting? How much is left? 8, 16, and then 3. Total? 6. 6, 16, 3. Total how much? 20, 5 parts. Total is equal to 17,500. You're asked about 16 parts. Yes. 25, how many times is 120, 175? 7 times. And then how many zeros are there? 2 zeros. 16, 7 times? 112. And then 2 zeros. 11,200 answer. Next, when a certain sum of money is invested for 12 years at 12% per annum, it amounts to 36,600. For how many years should the same sum of money be invested to earn the same amount of interest at the rate of 9.6%? See, if both the principles are same, if you are expecting same amount, same interest should be added. Are you getting my point? If you are expecting same amount, when principles are same, if the interests are same, then only amount will be same. Am I right or wrong? So it is enough to calculate interest in both the cases are equal. Correct? How much percent interest you will get in first case? 144%. In second case also, you should get same interest. Yes or no? At the rate of 9.6% per annum, in how many years will you get? 144%. In 10 years, how much you will get? 96. And in 5 years, half of this. Total 144. So to get 144%, how many years are required for us? 15 years. Following? If, see, amount in the sense, principal plus interest. You are expected to have same amount. Where principles are same, the same sum of money be invested. To have equal amount, you should have equal interest. Hence, we are taking that condition. A dealer offers 24% discount on the market price, thereby makes a loss of 5%. If there is 5% loss, it becomes 95% of cost price. And still there is a discount, this is after discount of 24%. If there is 24% discount, market price becomes 76% of market price. Are you getting? Next, I don't need that number 7500. How much discount should he offer on the market price so as to have a profit of 15%? If you are expecting 15% profit, it becomes 115% of cost price. 95 becomes 76. Decreased by 19, which is 20% of original number. What is 20%? 10% of original number? 9.5. 20%? 19. So when you are subtracting 19, that is subtracting 20%. What is 10% of this number? 11.5. 20%? 23. Subtract 23 from that. Subtract 23. 92%. It becomes 92% of market price. If it is 92% of market price, how much percent of discount is allowed? 8%, fourth option answer. Yes. A and B together can complete the work in 13 1 by 3 days, that is 40 by 3. B and C together can do it in 10 10 by 11 days, that is 120 by 11. If C's efficiency is more than B's efficiency by 20%, in how many days A, B, C together can complete that? Let's go for LCM of given numbers. 120. So total work is 120 units. A, B can do it in 40 by 3 days. So per day they can complete 9 units. 120 by 40 by 3. B and C can complete 120 units in 120 by 11 days. Per day they can complete 11 units. 120 by 11. And also you know that C's efficiency is 20% more than B's efficiency. So they are in the ratio 6:5. C efficiency becomes 120%, whereas B efficiency becomes how much? 100%. So they are in the ratio what? 6:5. Then C efficiency must be 6 and B efficiency must be 5. Together it is 11. Satisfied? They are in the ratio B to C, 5:6. Satisfied? And A and B together can complete 9 units. B alone can complete 5 units. So A will do 4 units. All together will complete 15 units. And to complete 120 units, how many days they need? 8 days. Follow? Next. At present, Ali is 14 years older to Kai and Eddie is 10 years elder to Kai. So one person is 14 years more than Kai's age, the other person is 10 years more than Kai's age. Then what is difference between 14 and 10? 4. So Eddie's age and Ali's age, difference is 4 years, right? At any point of time their age difference should be equal to 4. And you are also given respective ratio between Ali and Eddie, which is equal to 8:7. And here also age difference should be 4. In terms of number of parts from the ratio, age difference is 1 part, which should be equal to 4. From this, 8 parts is equal to 32. Yes or no? You are asked about Kai's age. See, if Ali's age is 32, we need to subtract 14 years from Ali's age to get Kai's age. Am I right? Subtract 14 from 32, that is 18. So Kai's present age is 18, but you are not asked about present age of Kai. You are asked about 6 years back. How much is that? 12. Follow? Next. A man pays 20% of his monthly salary as tax. Out of the remaining amount, he gives 1/4. What is remaining amount so far? 80%. What is 1/4 of it? 20%. 20% is gone. Remaining? 60%. And keeps 10,000 as petty cash. Remaining? 60% minus 10,000. Yes or no? And the rest he invested in LIC and fixed deposits in the ratio 3:5. And invested 14,350 in LIC. From the ratio, what is amount invested in LIC? How many parts? 3 parts. So 3 parts is equal to 14,250. Correct? Total is equal to 8 parts. Let me calculate horizontal comparison. 3 how many times? 4 times, 7 times, 5 times. Can I take this number as 5000 minus 250? If I want to calculate 8 parts, I need to multiply this number with 8. 5000 8 times? 40,000. 250 8 times? 2000. 40,000 minus 2000? 38,000. So 38,000 is 60% minus 10,000. 60,000, 60% minus 10,000. If you add 10,000 to this number, will that become 60%? How much is this? 48,000. 60% is equal to 48,000. Now your question is to identify tax amount which is 20%. To get 20%, you need to take 1/3 of it. 1/3 of it in the sense 16,000. The amount invested in LIC and fixed deposit is 60% minus 10,000. Hence, we are adding 10,000 to 38,000. Follow. Next. The area of the rectangle is equal to the area of the square whose diagonal is 8 root 10. If diagonal is 8 root 10, can I write it as 8 into root 2 into root 5? Diagonal in the sense a root 2? Yes. Root 2 cancel. 8 root 5. If side is equal to 8 root 5, area becomes 8 square, which is 64, into 5. Root 5 whole square is 5. Which is equal to area of the rectangle, which is length into breadth. And you know that difference between length and breadth of the rectangle is given as 4. So I want to write this number as product of two number combination. And I can write 64 as 16 into 4, and also I have into 5 here. If I multiply these two, how much you will get? 20. Is the difference between 16 and 20 is equal to 4? All conditions satisfied. So length is equal to 20. Breadth is equal to 16. L plus B, 36. 2 into L plus B, 72. Because you're asked about perimeter. You should be able to write 64 into 5 as product of two number combination, and you need to get difference between both the numbers as how much? 4. In a 120 liters of mixture of milk and water, the percentage of water is only 30%. The milkman gave 40 liters of this mixture to a customer. So remaining will be 80 liters. Out of 80 liters, you'll have milk and water in the ratio 70 and 30. Because in initial container, what is water percentage? 30%. Even if you take 40 liters of this content, remaining will also have 30% water. And even in 40 liters also, water will be 30%. Right. What is 30% of 80? 24. And remaining 56. This is milk. Am I right? After that, 12 liters of milk is added and 8 liters of water is added. How much you are adding now? 20. Already remaining is 80. And to this, if you add 20, total quantity becomes 100. And in 100 liters, milk will be 68 liters and water 32 liters. Am I right? Right. Now, what is your question about? Find the respective ratio between quantity of milk and water. Now, cancellation is with 4. 4 how many times? 17 times. 4 how many times? 8 times. 17 is to 8. Follow. Next. A bag contains 5 white, 5 red, and then 6 green balls. So total how many balls we have? 16. Now, if 2 balls are picked at random, in how many ways can you do that? 16C2. What is the probability that at least one is green? If you are asked about what at least one green, we will go for 1 minus probability of getting no green. Yes or no? No green in the sense, out of 6 balls, I should not get any ball. Am I right? So remaining how many balls we have? 10. Among those 10, you can pick any 2. So 1 minus 10C2 by 16C2. This value is equal to 10 into 9 by 16 into 15. 15 how many times? 6 times. 90 kada. 6 by 16 in the sense? 3 by 8. 1 minus 3 by 8 in the sense? 5 by 8. Are you following? Approximations. 2400 divided by root x into 50 divided by 25 is equal to 192. You can take 192 here and take this root 5 to root x to right hand side. Matladaru. So total value becomes 2400 into 50 by 25 into 192, which is equal to root x value. 25 how many times? 2 times. How much is this? 4800. divided by 192. Right, what is 10 times of denominator? What is 10 times of denominator? 1920. 20 times 3840. Still you have near about 1000 difference, right? 1000 in the sense, how many 122s will be there? Approximate 5. So total how much is this? 25. If root x is equal to 25, then x is equal to 25 square, which is 620. Ardhavainda? Don't go for exact values. You can even skip this. You can even verify something like other one. Yeah, edaina octal inka. What is 100 times of denominator? 19,200. Half of that, 9,600. Again, half of that, 4,000. Right, 25 times. Into x square minus 15 into 160 is equal to 33,600. How do we calculate 15 times? 10 times and then half? What is 10 times of 160? 1600. Half of that? 800. Right, total? 2400. Minus 2400 goes to right hand side and becomes plus 2400. And it becomes total 36,000. So 250 into x square is equal to 36,000. In 1000, how many 250s will be there? 4. How many thousands are here? 36. So 36 into 4. You can write this number as 6 square and this as 2 square. Total 12 square. Answer 12. Because you know that you have to calculate square value. Right hand side you already have squares. 6 square and then into 2 square, which is 12 square. Percent of 650 minus 86% of 358 plus how much is equal to 9 square. First of all, right hand side, how much you have? 81. So let me first calculate 56% of 650. What is 50%? 325. What is 5%? 32.5. What is 1%? 6.5. 32.5 plus 6.5? 39 plus 325, 364. Yes or no? This is 364. From this you have to subtract 86% of 360. Can I take this as 85% of 360? Only 1%, right? Am I right? Now, how do we get 85%? Or else simply you can do one more thing also. Instead of this, you can even calculate 90% of 350. Let's increase the percentage and decrease the number. Whatever it is, it's up to you. 85% or 90%? 85, sorry. You need to subtract 15%. What is 10% of this number? 36, 5%, 18, 36, 18, 54. If you subtract 54 from 360, how much you will get? 306. Right. Approximately how much is this? How much is this? 58. Take plus 58 to right hand side, that becomes minus 58. 23. Approximate 25. Next. A plus B into A minus B? A square minus B square. A plus B, 64 plus 24, 64 plus 26, 90, into 64 minus 26, 38, divided by 38, cancel, into root x, is equal to 3600, 90 how many times? 40 times. If root x is equal to 40, x is equal to 1600. Followed? Next, 8 into half, right? How much is that? 4. 4 times of this number. 4 into 4000, 16000. 200 into 4, 800. 5 into 4, 20. From this, you need to subtract 12,500. 4,320. Amma? 12,000, yeah. So this is 445. Yes. Made a mistake. 450 kada. Inda kenda seno? 16,820 minus 12,450. 4,370. I think earlier I wrote 12,500. ఇందాక ఇంతకు ముందు ఇక్కడ 12,500 రాసే కదా, అది మిస్టేక్. ఐ థింక్ ఆల్రెడీ కీ కెన్ డూ. నంబర్ ఆఫ్ వాచెస్ ఎక్స్పోర్టెడ్ బై కంట్రీ ఎమ్ డిక్రీజెస్ బై వాట్ పర్సెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ 2006 టు 2008. ఎమ్ ఫ్రమ్ 6 to 8. ఎమ్ డైమండ్ 2006 550, 2008 340. If 550 becomes 340, decreased by 210 from 550 into 100. Yes or no? Right. What is 10% of denominator? 55. 40% in the sense double, which is 220. From this you need to subtract 10. Yes or no? What is 1% of denominator? 5.5. 2%? 11. So you need not even subtract 11. అవునా కాదా? సో యూ నీడ్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ సబ్ట్రాక్ట్ 2%, బట్ క్లోజ్ టు 2%. లెట్ ఇట్ బి సమ్వేర్ అరౌండ్ 1.8% ఆర్ 1.9%. లెట్ మీ సబ్ట్రాక్ట్ 1.8%, నో ప్రాబ్లమ్. ఓకేనా? ఆన్సర్ షుడ్ బి 38.2%. వెరీ క్లోజ్ టు 38, బట్ మోర్ దెన్ 38. అవునా కాదా? తలలు దించండి. ఆప్షన్లు చూడండి అంటున్నా. తలలు దించండి అంటే తలలు ఎత్తారు మీ పాడే మీరు. ఎడ దొరికారబ్బా. How much? Yeah, 38 2 by 11. What is the sum of average number of watches exported by M in 2005-06 together and N in 2007-08? See, for these two numbers you have to calculate average, and for these two numbers also you have to calculate average. That is divided by 2, divided by 2, and after that again you need to add that. Yes or no? So instead of taking average two times, let's calculate the numbers first, take the sum, and then we'll go for average. Is it okay? Right, come on, next. 2005 and 6 M value. 2005 M, how much is this? 460. And then 550. 460, 550. 1000, 10. 2007 and 8 N values. N in 2007, 310. And here, 470. Total 780. Total 1790. Now go for average. 895. So basically you are supposed to divide first number with 2 and second number with 2, and then we have to add it, and then we have to add. So instead of that, add the numbers and then go for divided by average. What is the respective ratio between total number of watches exported by M, N together in 2005 and watches exported by the same countries together in 2006? M and N together in 2005. This value. How much is this? 260 and then 460. 260, 460. 720. And then 2006 values. These two. 550 and then 360. Total 920. Yes or no? 0, 0 cancel. Divided by 4 in the sense this is 18 and the denominator is 23. Okay. Next. If the number of watches exported by countries M and N decreased by 20% and 15% respectively from 2009 to 10, what was the total number of watches exported by M, N together in 2010? M decreases by 20%. M in 2009, how much is that? 560. If it decreases by 20%, 20% is 112. So finally it becomes 448. And this value N we have 320. This value decreases by what percent? 15%. What is 10%? 32. 5%? 16. 30 to 16? 48. Subtract 48 from this. That is 272. You need to add these two numbers. Avuna kada? Matladali. Inta? 720. 720. Next. Number of watches exported by country M in 2007 is what percent of total number of watches exported by countries M and together in 2004? M in 2007. M in 2007. This value, how much is that? 440. Is what percent of M, N together in 2004? This value. 260, 380. 260, 380. 640. Now, you need not to calculate answer. Just go to options and verify. 60s, 70s and 75s. So let's go for 75% direct. Matladali. What is 50%? 320. Yes or no? Right. To this, how much should be added here? 120. Yes. What is 10% of denominator? 64. 20%? Do we need to add 128? Less than that only, right? So can I take that number as somewhere around 18% or 19%? Matladali. So answer should be close to 69%. How many options we have? Only one. How to get idea of getting 70%? Options. అది ఎన్నిసార్లు పోద్ది అనేది మీరు మాన్యువల్గా క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయక్కర్లేదు కదా. మాట్లాడు. యు నీడ్ నాట్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? రైట్. నెక్స్ట్ 76. విచ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫాలోయింగ్ ఇయర్స్ ది వాల్యూ పర్ టన్ పర్ టిన్ టిన్నట్ అన్న పర్ టిన్ వాజ్ ది మ్యాక్సిమమ్ వాజ్ ది మినిమమ్ క్వాంటిటీ ఇన్ లాక్స్ అండ్ వాల్యూ ఇన్ క్రోడ్స్ సో పర్ టిన్ వాల్యూ హౌ విల్ యూ గెట్ ఇట్ ప్రైస్ బై క్వాంటిటీ ఎస్ సార్ ఇఫ్ యూ పర్చేస్ 5 pence ఫర్ 10 rupees వాట్ ఈస్ ది ప్రైస్ ఆఫ్ 1 pen 2 rupees హౌ డిడ్ యూ గెట్ 2 10 by 2. So total price by quantity purchased. Yes or no? So what is total price here? What is total price? Sorry. What is total price? 150. And what is total quantity? 100. Next. 150 by 75. Next. 330 by 150. Next. 400 by 160. Next. 500 by 200. See, as the values are almost round figures, we can directly calculate, right? Avuna kada? Need not to waste your time by writing this. Avuna? Right. Here, 150 by 100 in this in somewhere around 1.5. Here it is 2 times. So this cannot be your answer because you need to have minimum number. Avuna kada? So if you have something which is less than 1.5, then we have to consider. Avuna? Otherwise, 1997 is the only answer. Ardhamavutunda? This is more than 2 times. This cannot be your answer. This is also more than 2 times. This cannot be your answer. This is also more than 2 times. This cannot be your answer. Answer 1997. First one. Okay. Whatever, even if it is maximum or minimum, we will just go for comparison. We will try to eliminate every number except one. was the difference between number of tins of biscuit exported in 1999 and 2000? You just need to calculate the quantity difference. Am I right? Matladali. Quantity is blue color 150 and 160. How much is that? 10. What is given in numbers given in question? Lakhs kada? Avana? Lakh tins. Any lakhs? Any lakhs? 10 lakhs. Third one, right? Ten lakhs ante? 1 million. 10 lakhs is 1 million, which is 10^6. 1 billion in the sense? 1 billion in the sense? 1,000 millions. 1,000 millions are 100 crores, which is 10^9. 1,000 trillion kaadi idi, 1,000. 1,000, 10^3. 10^6, 1 million. 10^9, 1. Come on. Billion. Billion. What was the approximate percentage increase in export value from 97 to 2001? Export increase from 97 to 2001. 100 becomes 200. Antena. Export together? What was the approximate percent increase in export value? Export value abba. Export kaadu, export value. Export value in the sense amount. Yes or no? Right. 150 becomes 500. Increased by 350 from 150 into 100. Yes or no? Cancellation easy hai kada? What is 200% of denominator? 300. How much still you need to add? 50. Which is 1/3 of denominator? 1/3 of denominator in the sense 33, 1/3%. So total increase is 233, 1/3%. Approximate 235. If in 2000 the tins were exported at the same rate per tin as that in 1999, what would be the value of exports in 2000? 2000, how much quantity we have first of all? 160. But price would be what? Price would be how much? The amount that we have in 1999. Avana? Right. In 1999, how much quantity we have? 150. And that value becomes 330. And in 2000, how much we have? 160 quantity. This is quantity and this is price. Correct. How much it should be? What is 2 times of this? 300. What is 20% of 150? What I mean to say is, you need to multiply this number with 2.2. Are you following? 2 times is 300. 0.2 times is 30. When you add both, 330. What is 2 times? 320. 0.2 times 32. Total 352. Got it? What was the percentage drop in export quantity from 1997 to 1998? Quantity drop, 97 to 98. 100 becomes 78, decreased by 25 from 100. How much percent it is? 25%. Clear? Sure? Right. So I'll stop here for today. From tomorrow we'll discuss both clerk and PO. Okay.